Hello students, hope you all are doing well and following the classes also. In the previous class, we discussed the questions related to sum of n terms of AP and questions are from exercise 5.3. So some questions I discussed in the video class and some questions I gave you as homework. Hope you have all completed the homework. And today we'll discuss the questions from your textbook only. So all of you, please go through your textbook. We'll start with question number 15. In question number 15, as you can check, it was written, a contract on construction job specifies a penalty for delay of completion beyond a certain days as follows. So penalty is given in this way, Rs. 200 for the first day, Rs. 250 for the second day, Rs. 300 for the third day, and so on. So if we can check, if it is late for one day, penalty is Rs. 200, for 2 days it is equal to 250. So how much increase is there in the penalty? Yes, increase of 50 rupees. Now it was written, how much money the contractor has to pay as penalty if he has delayed the work by 30 days. Not for one day, the work is delayed by 30 days. So what is 30 here? How many days means how many terms? So n will be equal to 30. So it was given n is equal to 30. And this is the penalty which is charged. So here we can check the first term A is equal to 200 and common difference D is equal to second term minus first sum. So common difference will be equal to 50. Now what we have to calculate in this question? The penalty for 30 days. It is not asked the penalty for 30th day. Now I will tell you what is the difference. If it is asked in the question, find the penalty for 30th day. Means what we will calculate? Yes, we will calculate A30. But what is asked in the question? Find the penalty for 30 days. It was written, find the penalty for 30 days. So we have to find out the total penalty. Means what we have to find out? Yes, we have to find out S30. What was the formula for Sn? Yes, Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So we are substituting the value. In place of n, we have 30. So S30 will be equal to 30 by 2 into 2a. So 2 into 200 plus n minus 1. 30 minus 1 will be equal to 29 into d. So that will be equal to 50. 30 by 2 here we can cancel. So it will be equal to 15 into 2 into 200 will be equal to 400 plus 29 into 50, we can do the multiplication here. First 10 will come, then 5 9s are 45, carry over 4. 5 2s are 10, 10 plus 4 will be equal to 14. So it will be equal to now 15 into, we can add these two, so it will be equal to 4 into 4, then 5 plus 0, 5. 4. So we are getting 4 plus 4, 8. 1850. 54 will not come here. 0 only. So once again I will do 0 plus 0, 0. 5 plus 0, 5. 4 plus 4, 8. 1. So 1850. Now do the multiplication. So it will be equal to 15 into 0, 50. 0. 15 5s are 75, carry over 7. 15 8s are 120 plus 7 will be equal to 127. So carry over 12. 15 1s are 15. 15 plus 12 will be equal to 27. So penalty for 30 days will be equal to 27,750. So all of you write down this as answer. Penalty for 30 days is equal to 27,750. Method is clear? Yes. So moving on to the next question. Next question. A sum of Rs. 700 is to be used to give 7 cash prizes to the students. So how many rupees we have total? Yes, total we have 700 rupees. So 700 will be the sum. So we have SN is equal to 700. Now this 700 rupees should be given to how many students? To 7 cash prizes. So we have to give it to 7 students. So what we have here, N is equal to 7. And then it was given, if each prize is 20 rupees less than the preceding price, find the value of each of the prizes. And just giving you an example there. Suppose first price is 100 rupees. Then what will be the next one? 20 rupees less. Then what will be the next one? Yes, 80 rupees. Next one will be equal to 60 rupees. So in this way, if we will write, what is the common difference here? 80 minus 100. So that will be equal to minus 20. In the question, they gave the hint there. If it is not clear, we can just write one example there. So it was given in the question, each price is 20 rupees less than the 20 rupees less than the preceding price. So what we will write here, D is equal to minus 20. So rest all the information given, if we get the value of first price, then we can calculate all the prices. Means what we want? We want the value of first price, means we want the first term. Rest all the information given here. Now, SN is equal to 700 is given and N is equal to 7 is given. Meaning, S7 is equal to 700 is there. Now, we will substitute the value. Continue from here only. S7, according to the formula, 7 by 2 into 2A. A is the first term. So, we will write it as 2A plus N minus 1. 7 minus 1 will be equal to 6. D, in place of D what we have? Minus 20. N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D equal to 700 is given. Now what we can do? We can simplify this one, or 7 by 2 we can shift to right hand side. So here 2 is in denominator. When you will change the position, it will go to numerator and 7 will go to denominator, and here we will get 2a. 6 into minus 20 will be equal to, yes, minus 120 is equal to, here it will come 700 into 2 by 7. So we can cancel the terms here only. So we will get 2a minus 120 is equal to 200. Or from here 2a is equal to 200 plus 120. So 200 plus 120 will be equal to 320. So from here what we will get? A is equal to 320 divided by 2. So 320 divided by 2 will be equal to 160. So what we got? A is equal to 160. Solution is not over. What we want? We have to find the value of each prices. How many prices are there? 7 prices are there. So in that we got the first price. Directly you can write down the answer. Prices. The first price is 160 rupees. What will be the second price? What will be? Yes, 20 rupees less. So second price will be equal to 140. Third will be equal to 120. Then fourth, 100. Fifth, 80. 6th 60 and 7th will be equal to 40. The same question, if you will take D is equal to minus, in place of D minus 20, if you will take plus 20, then what you will get here? You will get A is equal to 40. Then to write the next prices, what you have to do? You have to add 20. So if you will take D is equal to 20, then also no problem there, but you will get the last money. Clear? Okay. So moving on to the next question. All of you can check the next question. Question number 17. It was written there. Students, they planned to plant trees. How it was decided that section, each class will plant same number of trees in which they are studying. Question is clear? Each class will plant the same number of trees in which they are studying. Means if the student is from first class, so first class, how many sections are there? In each class there are 3 sections. So in first class, suppose we have A, B, C, 3 sections. So how many plants first class students have to plant? Yes, section A 1, section B 1, section C 1. So total how many plants it will be equal to? 3 plants. Now if we will move to the second standard. Second standard again we have 3 sections there. So section A will plant 2, section B will plant 2 trees, section C also will plant 2 trees. So total it will be equal to 6. Now if we will move to third class, again 3 sections are there. Section A will plant 3. In which class they are studying, that much they have to plant. So section B also 3. Section C also will be equal to 3. So in this way, how many plants it will be equal to? 9. So in this way, each classes has to plant the trees there. In this way, total how many classes are there? Classes are there till 12th. So starting from first class to 12th class. Now we have to find out how many trees will be planted by the students there. So if we will write here, first term 3, 6, 9, etc. In this way, can you tell me total how many terms are there? We have to add. To find the number of trees, we have to add all these numbers. So to add all these numbers, we want how many numbers are there? Can you tell me? How many classes we have? First to 12. So how many classes are there? 12 classes. So we have to find the sum up to 12 terms. What is the first term here? A is equal to 3. Common difference D also is equal to 3. And N is equal to 12 we have. So what we have to find out? We have to find out S12. So now directly we'll substitute the value. S12 is equal to 12 by 2 into 2a. So 2 into 3, 6 plus n minus 1. 12 minus 1 will be equal to 11 into d. That is also equal to 3. So here we can cancel. 6 into 6 plus 11 into 3 will be equal to 33. So we will get 6 into 33 plus 6 will be equal to 39. Now we can multiply here. 6 into 39. 6 9s are 54. Carry over 5. 6 3s are 18. 18 plus 5 23. So we will get total how many plants were planted? 234 plants. So first, according to the class in which they are studying. So in each class we have 3 sections there. So in this way we got the AP, and since the classes are there from 1st to 12, we have taken number of terms is equal to 12. So at last, write down the answer statement. How many trees were planted? So 234 trees were planted. Clear? So moving on to the next question. All of you, you can check in your textbook. This is the diagram which is given in the textbook. In this diagram, we can check we have semicircles there, and it was given radius is the radius of first semicircle is equal to 0.5 centimeter. So starting from A to B, the distance is 0.5. Radius is given 0.5 centimeter, and L1 is the first semicircle. First semicircle L1 with radius 0.5. Now if we will check the second semicircle, this is the second semicircle we have. So for the second semicircle, what will be the radius? Yes, till here the radius was equal to 0.5. so for the second semicircle, this will be the radius. Till here the radius it will be equal to, so 0.5, and then it was given for the second one radius is equal to 1 centimeter. So for the first semicircle, radius is equal to 0.5. For the second semicircle, radius is equal to 1 centimeter. For the third semicircle, radius is equal to 1.5. So in this way, semicircles are drawn. And how many semicircles are there? 13 semicircles are there. So we have to find out the length of these 13 semicircles. Clear? Now I am showing you how we will do the question there. So moving on. So now we will find out the length of each semicircle. So first one, length of semicircle L1. So you can check in the diagram for L1, the radius was equal to 0.5. And what is the length of semicircle? Length of semicircle means its circumference. And circumference of circle is? Yes, circumference of circle is 2 pi r. So circumference of semicircle will be equal to its half. So 2 and 2 will get cancelled. So length of the semicircle will be equal to pi r. So length of first semicircle L1 will be equal to pi into 0.5. Correct? Now next one, length of semicircle L2 will be equal to, what was the radius of second one? Yes, 1. So it will be equal to 1 pi. Similarly, length of third semicircle will be equal to, yes, third semicircle is equal to 1.5 pi. So in this way, if we will write, we are getting in this way. Length of first semicircle, 0.5 pi. Length of second one is 1 pi. Length of third one is 1.5 pi. In this way, total how many semicircles are there? Total 13 semicircles are there. And we have to find out the sum of all these length. So what we have here, A is equal to 0.5 pi and N is equal to 13. Total 13 semicircles are there. And D, common difference we have to calculate there. So 1 pi minus 0.5. What will be 1 minus 0.5? Yes, 0.5. So it will be equal to 0.5. Pi. At present, don't substitute the value of pi. We'll simplify it and at last we can substitute the value of pi. So now we have to find the total of all these 13 semicircles. So we'll write down as 13 is equal to, yes, according to the formula, 13 by 2 into 2a. In place of a, what we have? 0.5. So 2 into 0.5 pi plus N minus 1. So 13 minus 1 will be equal to 12 into D, 0.5 pi. 13 by 2 we'll write as it is. Now we'll simplify it. 2 into 0.5 will be equal to 1 pi plus 12 fives are 60. In this way it will come and then we'll put the decimal sign here. So it will be equal to 6 pi. So 6 pi plus 1 pi will be equal to 7 pi. 13 by 2 into 7 pi. Now what we can do? We can substitute the value of pi. So we'll get 13 by 2 into 7 into 22 by 7. Here 7 and 7 will get cancelled. 2 and 22 also will get cancelled. And this one we can multiply. So 13 ones are 13. Carry over 1. 13 ones are 13 plus 1, 14. So length of these 13 semicircles is equal to 143. Clear? Yes, okay. So moving on to the next question. All of you, in this question, it was given 200 logs are stacked in the following manner. As you can check in the diagram, 200, total 200 pieces of woods are there and they are arranged in this way. In the bottom 20, then second 19, 18, in this way they arrange the pieces of wood. Now it was asked how many rows these 200 logs placed and how many logs are there in the top row. So how many rows are there, that we have to calculate. 1, 2, 3, 4. In this way, how many rows are there that we have to calculate. Means what we will calculate? How many rows? 1, 2, 3, 4, in this way. So we have to find the number. How many rows are there? So we have to find the value of n and how many logs are there? So suppose our n finishes here. How many logs are there in the top row? In this row, how many logs are there? What we will calculate? Yes, we will calculate an. How many pieces of wood are there in the nth row, last row? Clear? Total how many woods are there? 200. So what we have? Total. So we have Sn is equal to 200. And how to write the AP? It was given 20 in the bottom row, then 19, 18 in this way. So we have A is equal to 20, D is equal to 19 minus 20. So that will be equal to minus 1, and Sn already we wrote is equal to 200. So using this information, first what we will calculate, what is the value of n. So we'll start from here, Sn. So according to the formula, it will be equal to n by 2 into 2a. So 2 into 20 plus n minus 1 into d. D is equal to minus 1. Is equal to how much is given? 200. We'll simplify it. So it will come n by 2 into 20 into 2 will be equal to 40 minus n. Minus 1 into minus 1 will be equal to plus 1 is equal to 200. This 2 I am shifting to right hand side. So it will be equal to n into 40 plus 1 will be equal to 41 minus n is equal to 200 into 2 will be equal to 400. Now we'll multiply it. So we'll get n into 41n. So it will be equal to 41n minus n square is equal to 400. So which type of equation we are getting? Quadratic equation. So make one side equal to 0. So we can shift this expression also to right hand side. So we will get n square minus 41n plus 400 is equal to 0. Now we will solve it using quadratic formula. What was quadratic formula? Yes, minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. What we have a here? A means coefficient of n square. A is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 41, and c is equal to 400. Here we are calculating the value of n. So minus b, so minus of minus 41 plus or minus square root of b square. So minus 41 square minus 4ac. So 4 into 1 into 400 by 2a by 2. Minus into minus will be equal to plus. So 41 plus or minus square root of 41 square will be equal to 1681 minus 4 into 4, 1600 by 2. So 41 plus or minus square root of 81 by 2. So we will get 41 plus or minus 9 by 2. Square root of 81 is 9. So we'll check what are the two values of n, whether both the values are applicable or only one value is applicable. So first one will be equal to 41 plus 9 by 2 or 41 minus 9 by 2. 41 plus 9 by 2 will be equal to 41 plus 9, 50. 50 by 2 is 25. 41 minus 9 will be equal to 32. 32 by 2 is 16. So we are getting two values of n. But how it is possible? We are arranging the pieces of wood. So we will check which value is applicable. So n we have calculated, and then we have to calculate the number of logs in the top row. Top row means in this way we are arranging. So how many logs will be there in the last row? So we have to calculate an. So first I am taking when n is equal to 25. An formula was a plus n minus 1 into d. We'll substitute a is equal to 20 plus 25 minus 1 will be equal to 24 into minus 1. So 20 minus 24 will be equal to minus 4. Number of logs will never be negative. So this value not applicable. So we will check with n is equal to 16. So if n is equal to 16, we will get a n is equal to 20 plus n minus 1. So 16 minus 1, 15 into minus 1. So we will get 20 minus 15 is equal to 5. So this value is correct. So total 16 rows are there and number of logs in the last row is 5. Clear? Yes. So we'll move to the next question. All of you can check question number 20. Just read it. It was written there. In a potato race, a bucket is placed at the starting point. So this is the bucket, which is 5 meters from the first potato. So here, at the point of A, B, C, D, etc., potatoes are kept there. So the first potato is at a distance of 5 meters from the bucket and the other potatoes are placed at a distance of 3 meters. So total how many potatoes are there? 10 potatoes are there. Total how many potatoes? 10 are there. Now a competitor starts from the bucket, picks up the nearest potato and runs back with it, drops it in the bucket and runs back. So in this way, total how many distance should be covered? So first one, while moving to the distance A, the competitor has to start from where? From the bucket. So I am first one, distance covered. Distance covered in taking the first potato will be equal to, so competitor will move from here to here. So what will be the distance traveled? 5 meter. And then he or she picks up the potato and keep it in the bucket again. So again he has to turn back here. So what will be the total distance covered? 5 plus 5 will be equal to 10. So distance covered in taking the first potato will be equal to 10 meter. Then next distance covered, distance in taking the second one. Now the competitor is here. He has to move till here. Second potato is at the point B. So total how many distance? How much distance? 5 plus 3. So that will be equal to 8. And then again moving back there. So 8 plus 8 will be equal to 16 meter. Similarly, distance in third round. Distance in third round will be equal to, now again moving from here, till the point C. So 5 plus 3 plus 3. So 5 plus 3, 8. 8 plus 3, 11. And again moving back. So 11 plus 11 will be equal to 22 meters. So in this way, competitor will run. So now we'll write down it as AP. So first one is 10 meter. So we have our AP as 10, 16, 22, etc. In this way, how many potatoes are there? Yes, 10 potatoes are there. So we have total 10 terms there. What is the first term here? A is equal to 10. Common difference, D is equal to 16 minus 10. So will be equal to 6. And N is equal to, we have 10. So total distance covered, we have to calculate. So what we have to calculate? Yes, S 10. So according to the formula, it will be equal to 10 by 2 into 2A. So 2 into 10 plus N minus 1. So 10 minus 1, 9 into D. Here we can cancel, so it will be equal to 5 into 2 into 10, 20 plus 9, 6 are 54. So we will get 5 into 54 plus 20 will be equal to 74. So 5 4s are 20, carry over to 5 7s are 35 plus 2 is equal to 37. So total distance is equal to 370. So at last, write down the answer statement. Total distance covered is equal to 370 meter. Clear? Yes.